Hello! In this video, we will talk about both pull-up resistors as well as pull-down resistors and what happens if you don't use one. Say that we are reading an input signal with an Arduino analog pin, but the pin is not connected to anything. What will the Arduino report as the input when the state of the pin is read? Is it 0, 1023, or something in between? The answer is a randomly varying value between 0 and 1023. This phenomenon is called a floating pin. To prevent an unknown pin state, we need a pull-up or pull-down resistor connecting the pin to a known voltage. Let's take a look at this circuit with the digital pin connected to a button that is connected to ground. When the button is pressed, we get a low reading, as the pin is connected to ground. However, when the button is released, we have a floating pin. We could solve the problem by connecting the pin to 5 volts, which almost works, but shorts the circuit when the button is pressed, as the ground and power are connected directly. That is why we need a current limiting resistor between the input pin and the power supply. This resistor is called a pull-up resistor, and now the circuit works correctly. Pull-up resistors connect a pin to a high voltage. On the other hand, pull-down resistors connect a pin to ground. Otherwise, the working principles and the intended uses are the same for the two resistors. We are now demonstrating an example code called button. It uses a pull-down resistor to ensure that the circuit works properly. The used example code can be found from the Arduino IDE under File, Examples, Digital, Button. The example program reads the value of a button and turns on the built-in LED on the Arduino when the reading is high. To follow along, you will need an Arduino, a breadboard, some hookup wires, a button, and a 10,000 ohm resistor. First, connect the button to the breadboard. Use the notch in the breadboard to separate the terminals of the button. Connect one terminal to 5 volts and the other on the same side to ground with the resistor in between. Connect the opposing terminal of the button to digital pin 2. Next, let's take a look at the code. First, the pins of the button and LED are assigned to variables, and their modes are set accordingly in the setup function. At the start of the loop, the state of the button is read with the digital read function. Depending on the button state, the built-in LED is turned on or off. If the ground connection from the button wasn't there, then the read state would be erratic. If the pull-down resistor wasn't used, then the Arduino could take damage when the ground and 5 volt are directly connected. Well, what resistor should we use? It really depends on the amount of current needed in the circuit. In the example, we had a 5 volt input voltage and a 10,000 ohm resistor. This, according to Ohm's law, results in a 0.5 milliampere current. Such a small current is certainly safe for an Arduino. That's all for this video. Thank you for watching and see you in the next one.